Hey everybody, welcome back to Home Gym Hacks and Reviews, the place where equipment isn't just reviewed, it's also hacked. Today I'll be showing my favorite pieces of home gym equipment that range from $100 to $200. But this is the last time I'll be doing a video like this for a while, but the next video in this series is showing my favorite hacks, so make sure you hit the notification bell for that. Let's get to it. The first piece on my list is the PowerTech Leg Extension Leg Curl Attachment. This piece has undergone some improvements over the last few years. First off, there's a stainless steel weight horn. Secondly, the end caps bolt on. Thirdly, the tube that the roller pads fit on is now threaded, which helps to reinforce the tube. This piece sells for $189 with free shipping. It has a max weight capacity of 200 pounds. And basically, you're getting two quality exercises for $95 each. The leg extension function of this piece feels extremely smooth and effective, and I think it hangs pretty well with much more expensive commercial grade leg extensions. Similarly, the leg curl function of this attachment feels equally smooth and effective, and I think it hangs pretty well with much more expensive commercial grade pieces of equipment. You will need the flat incline decline workbench for this attachment, which sells for $429, but if you already have the workbench, this is a really good buy. Next up, I have the Everyday Essential Cable Machine Attachments. I got these for $129.99, and a year later, that's still what they're selling for. So basically, you're paying $25 for each attachment. I sold one of the five for $40, so I made some of my money back. I recommend getting a designated carabiner for each one of these attachments because the grommet is the weak link here. Aside from that, these are pretty durable pieces. I think most people have probably seen these by now, but they're, of course, knockoffs of the more expensive and nicer mag grips. First up is one of the 12-inch grips. I use this one for seated pulls. And what I find interesting about these grips is that I think Everyday Essentials was the first one to come out, or maybe Hawk Fit, but now there are all kinds of knockoffs of these knockoffs. Next, I have the other 12-inch grip. I use this one for seated pull-downs. And one of the things that I like about these knockoff mag grips is that I don't need to use straps, and they feel ergonomically correct, so there's no pain in my wrists or elbows or shoulders while I'm doing these exercises. Here's the 22-inch neutral grip attachment. I ended up selling the next one up, which was 24 inches, because it was just way too close in size to the 22-inch. But this feels effective, and I think it's my favorite of the five. I really like this width, but I'm also going to show you the next one up, which is the 33-inch, so you can see the difference in my hand width as I'm doing this pull-down movement. I don't use this one very often, but when I get to the point where I basically top out using that 22-inch and I've plateaued, then I'll switch over to this 33-inch pull-down attachment. And here's just a closer look at the 33-inch neutral grip attachment. Next up, I have the Titan Fitness Adjustable Height Dumbbell Holder. I thought this piece got discontinued, but it's still on Titan's webpage. Unfortunately, it is sold out. It presently sells for $114, and that's exactly what I paid for it almost 2 years ago. I think this piece is well worth that price, and it's one of the pieces that I use most often. In case you're wondering, I painted this black with bedliner paint. There are five different adjustments, so you can adjust this from 18.5 inches high to 26.5 inches high. You can adjust the width of the platforms from 13.5 inches to 21.5 inches. This piece only weighs 53 pounds, and each of these platforms or shelves are 17 inches by 7 inches. For exercises like heavy dumbbell shrugs, it's really a pain to get your dumbbells into position. So with these shelves, you can just put your dumbbells on, step right in, and shrug. As I mentioned in one of my other videos, one of my worst injuries came from trying to get 100-pound dumbbells off of the floor and into position for a chest press. So when I saw this dumbbell holder, I knew it was a piece that I wanted. And I really can't stress how nice it is to be able to take the dumbbells from this height and then get into position instead of trying to take them from the floor. Next, I have the Titan Fitness Angled Multi-Grip Barbell. I got this bar over a year ago for about $115, but it has jumped up in price to about $150. It's 48 pounds, it's 82.25 inches long, and it has a weight capacity of over 1,900 pounds. There are four sets of angled grips spaced 2 3/4 inches apart, and the knurling's pretty passive. I won't use a straight bar for bench presses anymore, but I do like doing bench presses with this angled grip. For me, it just feels much more comfortable for my elbows, shoulders, and wrists. And for the longest time, I always tried to get my bench press numbers up with a straight bar, and all it did was hurt my shoulders and my wrists. This bar also works really well for a reverse grip press if you want to hit your triceps. Again, there's no pain in the shoulders, wrists, or elbows when performing this exercise. This bar also works great for hammer curls and tricep extensions. I also like using this bar for push-ups. I'll elevate the bar with a couple of stall mats so that I can get my hands underneath, and then I'll use all the different grips for a variety of push-ups. It just feels much more comfortable on my elbows, shoulders, and wrists, and you can also flip the bar over and do reverse grip push-ups. Next up, I have the Titan Fitness Back Hyperextension Version 2. I got this over a year ago for $120. It has jumped up to $160. It only weighs 53 pounds. It has a 650-pound weight capacity. It's 2x2, 11-gauge steel, and that platform is pretty helpful because Titan's other model doesn't have it. While this piece does have its faults, mainly that the pads aren't that durable and the hardware is not that durable, it is an exceptional piece at that price. It's great for hip extensions, back extensions, and it's really easy to add a band to the exercise. The only complaint I've ever heard about this is that it may not fit someone who's 5'7 or less. Next up, I have the 65cm Bosu Balance Trainer. You'll see these in almost any fitness club you go to. I got this for about $120, and when I saw that it was a limited edition black model, I jumped on it because all of my equipment is black. Even my truck is blacked out. Bosu stands for both sides up, so you can use it with the ball facing down or the ball facing up. This one has a 350-pound weight capacity, and Bosu has other models that are less expensive and smaller. The Titan Fitness Tibia Dorsi Machine is the last piece on my list. It presently sells for $125. I think I got mine for right around the $100 mark with my loyalty points. It's 11-gauge steel. It only weighs 55 pounds. And it's one of those Titan Fitness pieces that just seems extremely well made, and it stands out among all of my other Titan Fitness pieces. This exercise works the tibialis anterior, the bottom front of your leg. It's one of those muscles that often gets neglected. And it feels really smooth, and it definitely feels effective. You can fit 25s on here, but it definitely won't fit 35s or 45s. And no weight capacity is listed, but it can handle whatever you throw at it. As always, thank you so much for watching, and thank you to the people who subscribe to this channel and support this channel by commenting and by liking these videos. If you haven't subscribed to this channel, please consider doing so. If you found anything in this video helpful, please consider giving it a like. And as I mentioned at the beginning of this video, in my next one, I'll be going over my favorite hacks of all time. And just to give you a sneak peek as to what I'm talking about, take this Titan Fitness seated leg curl leg extension, for example. There is this stop pin that can be easily removed, and if you remove this, you can transition much more easily between the leg extension and leg curl exercises. So in my next video, I'll be going over a bunch of hacks like that. Take care.